presented by Ontario, Canada, in partnership with Destination Ontario, Strike King Lure Company, St. Croix Rods.
You want to pitch for big bass? Some of the best bass I've ever caught in my entire life, even filming for my shows, have been by Pitchin and Flippin. But this rod specifically made by St. Croix, it's a Legend Tournament Bass Series, and it's a 7.5 heavy power, moderate fast action, so I can feel those light bites. A lot of times it's not just perfect when you just pitch by a dock, goes down, you feel tick, the line moves. What we're gonna do this afternoon, we're gonna fish some pads, heavy pads, and a lot of times there's frustration involved. You say, why frustration? Because when you lift any rod that you buy that's heavy action or heavy power, okay, it gets set hook, you can no problem catch the fish, but it's feeling those light bites. It's the difference of craftsmanship. That's what St. Croix offers. Okay, I'm gonna throw it with the little Daiwa casting reel, 20 pound gamma edge fluorocarbon, straight fluorocarbon, no leaders, no snaps, nothing, no braid. The water I'm gonna be fishing is a little off color, almost tea color, but I can see down 4 or 5 feet. If I can see down 4 or 5 feet, you know the bass can see it as well. All I want them to see is that little soft plastic. In this case, we're gonna use the rodent, okay? In the little moon juice color. Four rod, extra wide gap hook, pegged, 5/16 tungsten sinker, right down. So wherever I pitch this, I want it to fall in those holes, shake it a bit, reel in, pitch again. I'm gonna go into those pads, try in the real thick, heavy stuff. If they're not the heavy, thick stuff, come out to the edges, work the holes, but it's imperative that you use, if you don't have power poles, hey, pick up an anchor and stuff, but just don't go through areas too quickly. Fish slow and methodical, use the pitching stick, and you are gonna catch them like we will real soon. And what I'll do is I'll just keep picking it apart. I'll go from 9 o'clock to 12 to about 2, dissect all the little holes, then I'll pick up the power poles and maybe go about 10 to 12, 15 feet, a little bit more. So areas that I haven't pitched to, okay? But again, when you're doing this, just because you have the pitching rod, smooth reel, and you can make far pitches, it's a mistake. I mean a mistake to make those real far pitches in this stuff, you're asking for trouble. Even if I was using straight braid, I got 20 pound gamma edge fluorocarbon because the water is a little off color, but it's still, I can see the bottom at 5 feet, so I know that they can see the line, okay? Dissect an area, fish it efficiently, then move up and fish it again. Like that. Whoa. Get out of there. Look at him in those pads, hey? Look how he gets stuck. Uh-oh, yeah, he's stuck in those pads right there. Oh, no, is he out? He's out. Uh-oh, here he comes. Uh-oh. 2 3/4, sitting in the outer pads. That's why you gotta kind of keep pitching. Play with the pitching stick. So I'm gonna keep the trolling motor out. Find some fish on the outer stuff. 2.5 pounder, sitting on the pads. Okay, when I'm fishing inside the pads like this, see my bait? I got that big 4-rod hook, okay? So I got my soft plastic, push it on, up through, and it's tight. And see the nose coming up like this? Go up a bit like this and pinch it down. So I'm not frustrated by all those lily pads and the stems and stuff like that. I can go in, when a fish bites these soft plastics, no problem. Down it goes, hook set. Metal meets the meat. Push it up, bring it around the nose, get over that hook point. It just avoids frustration. You can keep your focus on fishing your bait on a soft bite and not worry about always getting, oh, is that weed? Oh, is that a stem? Is it a stump or rock or something inside the weeds? Keep your focus, peg the hook point. Always make sure that the tungsten weight is right against the hook eye, against the knot, and always check that last foot, 10 inches for abrasions, nicks, you name it. That fish showed me where they are. More on this outside, not way in there. Not where it looks beautiful. Out here. Yeah. Another one that's almost a twin of the other one. Tell me the power poles aren't worth every cent. I'm just sitting in one spot. Look, I'm not even moving. See that wind? It just moves the boat to the side. But it's just like having a little boat ramp or boat dock. See this stuff right here? I'm gonna show you this. See how sporadic it is? But it's the depth that matters. Now look back in there. Look how thick that is. Doesn't that look beautiful? Look at it. All that back there. It's all nice and thick. Looks like frog fishing. And you know what? I fished all that with nothing. Nothing. Not even a movement. So in this case, it's about the depth. Outer pads too. Maybe more aggressive fish. I found a lot of times when you get those better bites or quicker bites, they're on the outside because they're aggressive. So use the power poles, come back to almost the same spot I cut the other fish, and just slowly dissect it. You know, they just move through these things slow. If you drift over it with the motors down and the trolling motor, you're just gonna spook fish. Once one hit the trolling motor, it doesn't matter. Once you see them, they see you, they go, it's not. Put the poles down, dissect it, take your time, and that's why the 7.5 Pitchin stick is fantastic. When I found out that they're gonna come up with this rod right here, and the heavy power as well, and the moderate fast action, I said to myself, you know what? I'm gonna have a bunch of those rods, and I do. So let's keep going, see if we can get a couple more, and maybe one of the mothers of those fish right there. See how important it is to dissect those pads? You know, I wanna fish the thick stuff because the sun is high, it's warm, the water is 75 degrees, and I figure for sure with those real heavy pad sections, that'll be cooler water, the fish would be chilling, but that's not the case. The fish I'm catching are on the outside, in the more sporadic stuff. A little bit deeper water, but aggressive fish, okay? So different things like maybe perch, bluegills, and things like that, swimming on the outside edges and stuff. Those are the ones that are being caught. So a lot of times, yes, fish the real thick stuff you see, but do not neglect the outer stuff that's close to the edges, a bit more sporadic, but that's where the fish are this afternoon. Check it out. That's a nice fish. Right there. Ugh. Not the one I saw, but nothing wrong with that, boy. Whew. Did you ever pound that? I mean, just pound it in the pad, see? Making your pitches through the back cheek. Let's put them in there. Maybe 2.5, 2¾. Look at the backs on them. Nice looking fish. But catching bass in the nasty, the pitch and stick. You see what I mean about making those pitches all over? Two things, power pole, stay down, make the pitches, put it in, and let them have it. Just shake it, yo-yo it, up and down, keep moving. Don't just soak an area, wasting your time, you know? Keep moving, find the fish. So you're going fast and slow. What's fast and slow? Fast is you're picking apart those deeper outside ones. So every fish we've caught have been on the outside edges of the pads. So do you keep working the inside? It's very tempting, but time constraints, work the outsides first. If you don't get any fish, then maybe go back and fish that deeper, thicker stuff that has the real condensed pads. But so far, so good. Thanks to the Pitchin Stick Legend Tournament Bass. Okay, some of the features of that Legend Tournament Bass in the Pitchin Stick, it's got integrated polycurve mandrel technology, okay? And it's high modulus, high strain carbon with fortified resin system for unparalleled strength and durability. It's got Fuji K-Series tangle-free guides with alkanite rings and corrosion control silver finished frames, like real beautiful looking rods. They got the Fuji PTS blank touch reel seat, split grip, super great cork handles, two coats of flex coat, slow cure finish, and these rods have the 15 year transferable warranty backed by St. Croix Superstar Service. Okay, let's move up a little bit more again, because these aggressive ones are close to this outer edge. We don't want to spook them. Keep your bait wet. All while you're moving, get up about 10, 15 feet, and I can fish all the stuff here again. Right there. See what I mean about bouncing the bait? Just bouncing the bait like this. So you have that softer tip. I can feel those light bites or any pickups, but man, it's got the strength up through here. When I set hook, that metal finds the meat. So one pounder, he was in a big fish spot. You know what a big fish spot looks like? Little pad section right there in front of me. Not a giant, not even a keeper, but 6 for 6. Hooking percentage is psychotic with this rod, really. You think even with that tip, you know, the moderately fast, it just picks up, helps me put that metal to meet the meat. A couple more fish, and we're gone for the day. So I'm gonna pull up about 10 feet, go up to the side, so I can fish some of this. This right here, that's good looking stuff. I have a lot of perimeter right here to fish. And I move up only about 10, 15 feet. I got a lot more holes to hit. Let's see if I can catch a big one. One of the ones I saw. Those are nice. Love how they fight. Whack! Then they just go. Fight like the largemouth I know. Nice and tough. Big one of the day, right at the end, huh? Come on, boys. Look at this stuff, man. Screams largemouth. Let's keep moving up along these dark. Nope. Look at that. Moving that bait. Catch another chunk. 2 pound chunk. In the jaw. Right when I was bringing it on the outside edge. Now, is the afternoon the witching hour? Oh, it's the witching hour. Let's let him go right here. Hey, boy, huh? Hold on. That's why you use those sunglasses. You want to fish in the sun and protect your eyes. You have to wear eyewear, polarized, so you can actually see down. Polarization, it cuts the UV rays and the bad rays that hurt your eyes. But man, fishing without it is just going to hurt your eyes. You're going to miss so many things, like reading underwater structure cover, fish moving, movement, different depths in the bottom. You got to have them. And now it's time for the extreme edge. All right, this is going to be about the two-prong approach for finding smallmouth in summer. Number one is going to be my Rage Menace with the Legend Tournament Bass, flipping and pitching into all the highest potential spots. But it could just waste a lot of time all day between that stuff looking for fish. So what's the two prong? I got the Menace on a medium heavy action casting rod with 16 pound test, the low profile Daiwa. But to find the smallmouth, right here, it's the 7-1 medium power Legend Tournament Bass with the 2.75 inch Rage Swimmer. How am I gonna find in between? Right like this. Casting, let it sink, engage, and slow roll. You will find so many more fish by picking up that little swim bait and fishing it between all the good stuff. You say, what's the good stuff? Well, you don't wanna just run to rock piles, docks, cribs, and things like that, because you're missing all the opportunity of fish that are just cruising, holding on a point or somewhere. This little bait, that kick and tail, will find them. So you're maximizing all the water between. Say, well, is it dead water? It's dead to an extent of me just sitting there pitching, working it slow, but there is fish roaming. Okay, let me throw the little Rage Swimmer first. And what am I looking for? These early summer smallmouth, okay? They cruise between 3 feet, 6, 7 feet, on rock edges and gravel and things like that. So what I'm gonna look for, I got the Garmin on side view, I can see out looking for rocks and stuff. So I'm going through areas about 10, 12 feet of water, and I got it 200 feet to my distance. And I can see with those rock piles where I can't see visually with my eyes and I'm driving slow. So it helps me find those areas where the smallmouth are. So I'm just gonna throw that little right swimmer along those areas by the rocks. It's calm, it's a perfect, beautiful early summer day. They are feeding. So don't just stay on an area and you say to yourself, well, man, they should be here. That's a big mistake in fishing, thinking, well, they should be here. If they're not there, don't be stubborn. Go to the spots that already produced, showed you where fish are. Do a milk run, don't be embarrassed, just go for it. Don't care what anybody thinks, go for it. Use your instincts, great swimmer, find those aggressive fish, because you know when that sun gets higher and they finish doing that morning feed, things can get a little tougher. Oh, good one too. Look at that. That's a nice brownie, hey? I'd say, sitting on that little rocky point. Sitting on that little rocky point. Wow. Search and destroy, man. He ain't caught yet, but you know what? It is sure fun finding them when you got a 1-2 punch. And that's when he's safe right there. That's when he's safe. Keep him off the carpet. Right there. Look at that. I'm gonna show you something about using the net. There's my bait. As soon as you grab the fish, it falls out. Look how long that fish is, dude. Okay. I would have lost that. I would have said, oh, it's about 6 pounds or so. But just a beautiful smallmouth, which we'll let go right away, okay? Let's let him go right away. Hey, Mr. Smallmouth, you're proved. Go on, just make a long cast, let it sink. Come around, I see a gravel bar coming out, and I fish the main point, I'm thinking, nah. I go a little farther, where the gravel comes out, make that long pitch, boom, get a 3-pound smallmouth. So sometimes, when you're about to make your last cast, think about it. Make 2 or 3 more past the areas that you think the fish are at, and you'll catch more fish. Think about the 2-prong approach next time you're out. The little rage swimmer to find the fish between the hot spots and then pick up the rage menace, because sometimes they don't want to chase, but they'll eat the menace hopped and popped on the bottom. Can't tell you how dangerous that is. How scary dangerous that is. This is where you catch 7-pound Ontario largemouth. This kind of stuff right here. It seems to be a really good September thing when the water drops. Seems like these fish know the big trees, eh? They know it. Last time I was in the tree yo-yoing it at that big largemouth, I knew I felt them. Look at that big bronze one, eh? Look what lives in here too. Just pitching straight down. Wow. Crazy, look at that. Hey, wow. Tough. Oh, boy. In the deep trees, huh? Big smallies too, pitching in that trees, boy. Look at that. That's a pretty big, thick fish, isn't you think? Sitting inside there, right inside the tree, yo-yoing it. I'm gonna introduce you to some of your green fish, okay? Let's see. Uh-oh, the largemouth say, what is that? What did you put that green thing in there with me? Don't be scared to pitch into the thick, crazy stuff. You got the right line, 20 pound. Think about it, I'm not catching 20 pound bass. Everyone knows it. You can't overline. You need the thick stuff. Do you see how you wrapped in that stuff and how I had to pull them out of there? I mean, I check it, but man, it's tough. It's tough. There's no abrasions. There's nothing. Passing trees. go back around, because I know that maybe one of these trees behind me, beside me, in front of me, gonna have a big largemouth. Whew. Well, you think I like this rod? Man, had a nice afternoon catching a bunch of largemouth, you know, chunks in those outer pads, and a real nice bonus smallmouth in that deep tree. But I could pitch and yo-yo it, 7.5, got the power, and you know if you can pull those smallmouth out of those deep trees, that you've got some backbone sensitivity, feel that, dunk, dunk, dunk. All of a sudden there's weight, arr, got them, pulled them out. So the 7.5 pitch and stick, Legend Tournament Bass by St. Croix, put it in your budget, use the rod, pitch as much as you can to all the good looking stuff on shorelines, trees, docks, you name it. It's made for pitching, it's made for catching big fish, and best of all, it's made for you.
Experience Northern Ontario for yourself, Region 12, and the fantastic bass fishing. Visit them at www.rto12.ca or call 1-800-835-7303. Xtreme Angler has been presented by Ontario, Canada, in partnership with Destination Ontario, St. Croix Rods, Strike King Lure Company, Rage Tail Soft Baits, Gamma Fishing Lines, Power Pole. Visit us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.